here today. Today I'll be running through with you how to do self-diagnostics of your home Ethernet points, namely those you find like on the walls, right? Using one of these little babies here. So this is actually a general cable tester. Stated here, it does a diagnostic check using the RJ11 as well as the RJ45 standard. So RJ11 is the format for your typical phone jacks. Phone jacks is just the other term of it. And Ethernet points or Ethernet cables with 8 pins is the RJ45 standard. So this allows you to test the continuity of the 8 pins on the RJ45 as well as the 6 pins on the RJ11. So as shown here. So there's two parts to this remote. There is the main unit as well as a remote unit, as it says on the tin here. It's actually removable. So what you have, right, is actually a standalone unit powered by a battery. So this runs off a 9-volt battery. And there are two ports up here, right? Smaller one with the 6 pins is the RJ11 phone line jack, and the one down here is the 8-pin RJ45. And you find the corresponding same pins as well on the remote, the smaller one phone jack as well as the Ethernet point. So for the for this video, I'll be using this demonstration on my Ethernet points, and the procedures to test your phone jack is largely similar. Alright, let's get into it then. So what's in the box then? Okay, so we have two units and it comes in this little pouch here. So this whole thing, I got it off eBay, costed just under about $8 US or about like 10 to 11 Sing dollars. So what you get is actually pretty basic, you know, just the units in here, no cables. These are my cables, and you just get, well, pretty much, yeah, just a universal instruction sheet here, network cable tester. So this unit, right, conforms to the T568 standards, which is the standard which everybody uses, especially if you're talking about networking in the home. So I believe this actually gives you a bit of the technicalities of how it goes about testing it. So yeah, as elaborated, there's 8 pins on the RJ45 as well as the 6 pins over here. And of course, yep, says it conforms to the two standards of the T568 standards here, and nothing really much about it. There is additional testing for RJ12, but it's not going to be covered here because I don't really have RJ12 cables to begin with. So let's get tested, okay? So right, to begin with, I shall plug in all the Ethernet points up here onto the big port. So this is a 8-pin Ethernet jack, which what you can typically find in the back of your desktop computer or your laptop computer if you have one. You may need a dongle if your laptop is, you know, an Apple product, I guess. Right, so, and then the other end goes up here, okay? Right, let's get it down. So what you have is the device connected via the cable. So there's no battery in this. So anything which lights up here, right, means that the power actually comes through this cable. Well, this has a battery in it, and turning it on, it actually runs through a continuity. So what it does here, right, is that it sends a signal through each of the pins. Right, so if I have another pin down, another jack here, there's 1 to 8 pins, right, you can see right there. And these are straight cables. So if it's a straight cable, you'll get a corresponding similarity of 1 being tacked onto 1 here. So as you can see, it runs through everything. So 1 corresponds to 1 here. It means that, you know, there is actually a signal running through from here to there. So when all of them lights up, you can tell that this is a good cable. Good cable means in the sense that all the pins are connected and there's continuity in there. So that's why it checks. You notice that if G doesn't light up, G is actually a ground signal, and that only applies to cables which are shielded, you know, with ground shields, and usually that's not really needed for a home internet networking. You know, it's more like for areas where you have large interference, you know, outdoor and yeah. But so within the purview of home networking, at least, like So 1 to 8 is really what you need to do. So there's actually two modes. So on quickly cycles through all the 8 pins. If you have a phone jack in place, you will get signals running through all of them, but you will only need to check the 6 corresponding on both sides. So if you run a phone jack through here, you will get the main unit running through 1 to 8, but you wouldn't get a feedback from 6 to 8 onwards. So it's just simple. So you just need to check 6 for RJ11 and 1 to 8 for RJ45. Okay? This is actually a status LED, you know, it just shows that, you know, it's like doing stuff, and then this is actually what you really need to take a look about. So the S mode here, right, you know, it's actually what I think is called the slow mode. So if you switch it over, it holds the LEDs, right, a bit longer, so you can actually check so that you don't miss out on any of the continuities. So likewise, right, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then it goes back up again to 1. Yep, so that's about it. Before I go about checking continuity, right, it's good to have at least 2 sets of cables. So I've checked this yellow cable, and next I shall check this spare cable I have here, which is this black one here. Similarly, just run it through there. So the reason why I want to check these two, right, so to make sure that you don't have any inherent system issues. You gotta make sure these two cables are good before you go around checking the ports in your house, whether they are actually working or not, right? So let's run this again. So alright, there's 8 of them in there. And I shall leave this black cable on the remote side and the main unit using the first cable which we tested, because the jacks on the wall, they are the female ports, so there's no way for you to connect this directly to that without using a cable. Hence, you got to make sure that these two cables are okay before you actually go about testing. And because if there is anything wrong with the continuity or the patchwork right behind the walls, that's how you can actually tell whether the cables are faulty using proper cables here. So let's go about doing that. So if you are staying in an apartment, you will normally find a panel by your main door. Alright, and it's usually something like that. So everything sits, you have your fuse box and a network box up there. So what you have in here is essentially what you have, you know, like your fiber termination points, your phone jacks, as well as your Ethernet ports and your TV aerial lines. So the things that are of interest will of course be your data port panel. So this apartment I'm in is a 3-bedroom apartment. So the labelings as such, living room. Alright, let's get some focus here. And then that's the first bedroom, second bedroom, and the master bedroom. Each of these panels are 8 pins, actually 45. And then there's one here for the phone jack. So in this format, the living room port runs out straight to the wall over there, and there is another jack here which is a phone jack, distinguished by this phone icon here, which connects to the phone line up here. Alright, so with this in hand, I shall test the connection for this port here to the living room port. Right, let's just do this with one hand. And yeah, alright. Right, so that's connected from the living room port to the RJ45 port on the tester unit. And I shall leave it on. So you can see it cycles through. Alright. So it's sending the signal through. Alright. So let's leave it on here and let's go on to the other port. And put this other end into the other wall port here. So the pins are here, so it goes on this way. And ta-da! As you can see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Right? And usually this is all what you need to do. You just need to check whether all 8 is lit here, because the unit back there at the box where it sends the signal from has the battery power, and this one doesn't have any battery. So anything you see here is exactly what you see here. But just to confirm, I just leave this here and we head onto the other box. And you can see, similarly, all 1 to 8 LEDs have been lit here. And there you have it, the connection from the living room port here to the wall port where the other one is connected is okay. Alright, do take note though that this tester, right, doesn't actually distinguishes between the categories of your cables. So if this is a Cat 5 cable, if you were to use a Cat 6 cable, they are all 8 pin cables. The only difference between the cables is the shielding and how resilient they are to electromagnetic interference, with the exception of concerning twisted pairs, you know, and stuff like that. So it's just a thicker cable, better cable, better quality cable, and less interference, which allows you to achieve gigabit speeds using the same number of pins. So actually, this is all what you need. Most new apartments, like this one here, comes with Cat 6 cabling as standard. So they're actually pretty good cables running through the conduits to each of your bedrooms, so you don't really need to worry about that. Yeah. So the main thing is just to check that whether your internal wirings as well as the termination on your patch point here is done properly. Usually 99% of connection issues regards to Ethernet points inbuilt one are normally limited to the improper connections on the patch panel side. So usually the chances of you having to rerun and re-pull your cables is very low. Most of the problems usually reside here, and this is a nice handy tool to allow you to just quickly do that. So so the procedure is the same for the other bedrooms. I can just do the same again and illustrate to you. I put it in here and I will just go to here and bring this to the first bedroom. So the procedures are the same as well. Alright, so this is the port in the one of the bedrooms here. Note that this is an Ethernet jack here, and ta-da. And there you have it, the 8 LEDs, right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 are all similarly being lit here. So we can tell that this room now has a direct proper connection through 8 pins to the main box in the living room, right. To sum up the how networking is typically done here, okay, so I've run through how you can check that the continuity and the connection between each of the bedrooms are proper and terminated properly to your bedrooms. How would you actually set up your networking equipment here then? Alright, so we have a power jack here, alright, and this is where you typically put your optical network terminal, or ONT for short, as well as your router. So usually it will reside here. So that box up there is actually your fiber termination point, and that comes up through a fiber cable into your optical network terminal, ONT, and that has four outputs, or rather say two different kind of outputs. That is, if you have a voice line subscription, you will have a RJ11 port, which is a phone jack, and that goes on using a cable into your phone jack, and that brings phone lines direct to all the rooms which you have phone line ports in. And then there is a RJ45, aka your Ethernet port, which goes into your router, into the WAN port of your router, and that actually through DHCP, you know, or whatever static address assignment, connects from your router using an RJ45 cable to each of the individual rooms. So what you can see is fiber point, ONT, router connected to your ONT, and the four ports of your router, each port goes into each of these ports here, each of them representing a spot in your room. So usually that's how I'll be setting up. So there'll be one port on the router going into the living room port, master bedroom, and the two bedrooms, and you have the ability to connect to the same LAN subnet through every single room in the house. If you're looking to add more ports, you can choose to have a switch terminated at the endpoint in the bedrooms. So if you have like more networking devices, a server or like a home port, or you know, like a TV box which you wish to connect to, then it'll be recommended, given the restricted number of ports here, to actually split the ports on the endpoint in the rooms with a switch, so that you can actually expand the number of ports in your room on the same LAN subnet with your router over here. So that's usually how it goes then. So everything will sit here, the ONT and the router, and then if you're looking to expand your network, you can choose to connect your mesh routers, your APs or repeaters in each of the respective bedrooms from the ports in the bedrooms and not here. Because you won't really get good Wi-Fi signal putting all your net equipment in this corner of the house, which is usually by the front door, behind a cabinet. This is a wooden cabinet, so you don't really get significant attenuation, you know, on the Wi-Fi signal, but this is not really one of the best spots, you know, to put network equipment, given the interference you have from high voltage fuse box here, as well as the number of metal parts around here, you know, that just makes Wi-Fi a little bit more painful to get, especially on the far ends of the room, especially or in the master bedroom for this three-bedroom apartment room has come to concern. So yep, hope you enjoyed this video. It's a quick 101 networking session. I might work on the additional video with the exact details of setting up the network infra if time allows, but yeah, this is pretty much mostly a video on how to actually test your network using one of these babies here. So yeah, if you find the video useful, just feel free to give it a thumbs up, subscribe if me, and hope to see you again soon then. Alright, bye.